Alright guys, it's cleanup time. So, for today's video, I don't really have a whole lot planned. Mostly just to clear out everything. Just organize, get everything up to spiff, you know. I bought some shelves so that I could actually kind of start stacking things, make more space for myself personally. And, you know, 2022, this year, let's get something done. I'm tired of waiting. I'm tired of sitting around. I'm tired of being a lazy piece of shit, if I'm being honest. So, we just need to just do something. So today, I finally got the urge to just clean up my garage, clean up my storage unit. Yeah, let's get to it. Hope you guys enjoy. From here on out, it's gonna be a time lapse. So yeah, have fun. All right, guys. So I've already kind of like, not spilled the beans, but more or less just cleaned up and didn't record. So I apologize. But I mean, I'm not all the way done. This is kind of just what I got. I have some parts for sale if you guys are interested. Two Ford Taurus headlights and a 1999 EVAP canister for a Camry. A 1999 Camry. Got those for sale if you guys are interested. But, you know, just cleaning up still. Having fun. This is what I got done. Rearranged the motor, some of the tires, put my intercooler right there. I know that's not a safe spot. I'll move it. Trust me. You know, just kind of just trying to organize. I know I'm real shitty at it, but I mean, at least I'm trying. You know what I mean? I'm going to be grabbing some more shelves here in just a moment, because those two worked, but I think I need some more just to stack more stuff. You know, I'm debating on selling my Z31 spoiler and the rear taillight, because I've been looking around and I feel like I can find a better spoiler on the rear. But then at the same time, having no spoiler on the rear too, that's pretty legit as well. So I don't know, but yeah, I'm going to be giving you guys an update on what I got coming for 2022 and like updates and all that fun stuff. And yeah, so stay tuned. Alright guys, so this is what I got done. It took me about like an hour and a half, I would say. Oh yeah, and then this is like part two, or second half of like everything of like, you know, organization and all that fun stuff. So here it is. I'm not finished yet, okay? Bear with me, I'm not finished, but it's kind of like stuff that I need to take to Richfield / stuff that needs to go to the other cars down there. We got jack stands all up there. H22A I have for sale. Yeah, it's a Honda motor. I'll show you guys more about that. The spare from a Z, all that fun stuff. Intercooler piping. This is all Snap-on tools that I got from like a flea market, so I got to go through that still. So that's kind of why it's scattered. Don't really care about it. They're kind of just freebies, you know. But we got my intercooler right there, my spoiler. I know it's kind of shitty, but like this is all kind of like quick and thrown together, just real fast, real quick. You guys saw me build these two shelves, or these three extra shelves right here. This one was already pre-built and I just grabbed it, you know. It's gonna serve as like a nice little toolbox, tool holder, you know. So like, literally, I just have to come over here, grab my tools, call it a day, you know. This is gonna be like my makeshift toolbox, I decided. I'm gonna throw some more slaps on the inside. See, I got an Iconic. I'm gonna throw my other Iconic one in there. I got Streeties. Shout out to my boy Streeties, you know. JP Streeties, all that fun stuff. We got the VG30 motor right there, my DoorDash shit. You got extra cylinder heads, intake, turbo, all this fun stuff. We're gonna be redoing the U-joints in that drive line, or replacing that whole drive line. We're gonna try, not necessarily rebuild the transmission, but I'm gonna have a guy fix it for me. I know a hookup, and he's gonna basically rebuild the whole transmission, put brand new synchros, all that fun stuff. He's actually gonna finish the third gear shift fork that I broke before. He's gonna finish that for me, all that fun stuff. And then after that, oh yeah, the cool thing about this transmission, it's a T5, so it's a non-world class T5. Non-world class T5s are usually found in like many Nissans, Isuzus, various other Jeeps and stuff like that. The only difference between a world class and a non-world class is world class, they have like roller bearings as well as like race bearings is what I think that's what they're called. These ones, they're just solid. They're just a solid shaft, and they basically just squeeze and press everything together. Here, let me show you. So like, you know, that's what I'm talking about, all the gears and all that fun stuff, you know, all that good shit. But yeah, we're gonna have that dude fix it for me, get this transmission all nice and beefed up. I think I'm just gonna roll with this transmission. I remember before I was like talking a whole bunch of shit about how the non-world class T5s are just junk, they're trash, all that. Actually, these are actually known to hold up to 300 to 600 horsepower stock, and that's a T5 transmission in 300Zs. How I know that is because I've seen a lot of people run them, and not only that, they're just very known in the Z31 world. And so I'm kind of like taking back my world where I said the FS571C, the transmission found in most NA Z31s as well as 240s. I was saying that one was like the second strongest, or you know, the best second option. I lied, guys, so I apologize for giving you guys false information on that. The second best will always be the T5, the non-world class T5. Just because parts are easy to find, you just gotta look up non-world class T5 or FS5R90A. 90A, FS5R90A, and it'll pull up the non-world class T5 for you. Going back to it again, this is the second option always. You just gotta watch out for the shift forks. The shift forks will completely shave themselves off, you know, go grandpa. They'll have no teeth, like literally. So, like I said, just watch out for the shift forks. Be really nice and gentle when shifting. Don't Dominic Toretto that shit, because you're gonna break it, obviously. I didn't do that, but the previous owner did. I thought my third and fourth was gone, but third and fourth, it was still there. It was just a broken shift fork, so lucked out there. But yeah, like I said, we got big things coming for 2022. Oh yeah, I'm kind of tired of just like talking and just saying like I'm gonna be doing this, I'm gonna be doing that, I'm gonna do that. You know, I'm tired of beating around the bush. This year, I really want to get my 300Z going. We're gonna do it again. We're gonna try to beat my birthday. My birthday is June 4th of this year, and we're gonna try and get my Z running before then. So let's see. Right now it's March, April, May, June. So we've got about 3 months. That's doable, and that's plenty of time in all honesty. Basically, I've come to the conclusion that what happened was when I was putting my 300Z together, I put all the cam gears together and all that fun stuff, you know, these bad boys. You guys gotta remember, these bad boys are kind of fucky in my opinion. So if you guys look right here, it says, oops, let me flip it over, R3. And if you look over here on this other one, it'll say L3. Yeah, so I'm mad at myself for this. I'm retarded, but my car runs like shit because I swapped the cam gears. So for anybody that knows, the left side is always the driver's side and the right side is always going to be the passenger side. So let's pretend that this is my motor, you know, the VG30, and we're looking at it like this. So my dumbass, when I was doing all the timing belt and stuff, pretend that the motor's right here, all that, I decided that, you know, since the driver's side is on the right-hand side, I'm gonna put the right, like R3, on the driver's side, and then put L3 on the passenger side, you know? So, you know what I mean? That seems legit, seems correct, all that fun stuff. Well, turns out it's the opposite. Right-hand side goes on the left-hand side, and left-hand side goes on the right-hand side, aka left equals driver's side, right equals passenger side. So it's always going to be as if you're facing the front. So again, left and right. My dumbass didn't know that. I swapped the cam gears, and that's why my car runs like shit. So literally, all I gotta do is swap those cam gears, and maybe my car will be able to have much better timing, much better power, much better everything. I'm literally like so salty at myself, but I mean, you live and you learn. And you know, this is my first legitimate sports car chassis that I've ever had in my goddamn life. So I'm literally doing the best I can. And you can't, it's really hard with this car, the Z31 specifically, because you know, there's Mustangs, there's Beamers, there's 240s, there's tons of aftermarket parts for those vehicles. Z31, you have to know exactly what you're looking for, and you have to know what cross parts and what cross reference things that you can use specifically for your Z31. I found out many Frontiers, many Xterras, many, some 240 parts actually fit too as well, S13 specifically, S14 stuff too, but like, you know, you kind of figure out like a niche between the all of the worlds, all the Nissan worlds, and it's pretty nice. That's what I love about the Nissan 300ZX the most, is because you can literally Frankenstein the shit out of it and still make it run and beat a lot of 240s. I'm not talking crap, Brian, but I think it is time that the Z31s do beat out S13s. I'm going to be one of the few people that does do that. Hold my word. Hold it against me. Okay, Brian? But, yeah. Trying to think. What else? I don't know. Nothing too crazy. Just 2022. I'm ready to not be a bitch. I'm ready to not be lazy. I'm ready to do some shit. Yeah, you know? Let's go. Again, if you guys are new to the channel, thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys like my organization. There will be a part 3, I finish, so stay tuned for that. But you know, more videos to come. Not entirely sure what else I'll be refilming besides drifting, but yeah, big things happening in 2022, so stay tuned. If you guys are new, subscribe to my channel, link is down in this description. Follow my Instagram, I don't have a Twitter anymore. I deleted that. Follow my Instagram. Follow my TikTok. I got TikTok now. Yeah. Buy some merch. I also have some merch too. Grab some merch for, you know, joining me. Be an iconic drift member, you know. Grab a hoodie. Grab some t-shirts, you know. All that fun stuff. I will have some more designs coming out. I am going to make myself a Grim Reaper design. I was going to have one that came out soon, but plans changed. So I'm gonna design my own Grim Reaper. I'm gonna design my own shit, I decided, because I found out that I have a creative, artistic side. So I've never shown it, but I'm gonna show it now, because why the fuck not? And oh yeah, I'm gonna rap too. I decided I'm gonna start rapping. I know everybody's like, oh my god, you're gonna be a fucking rapper. Oh my god, like, why the fuck are you gonna be a rapper? I'm just gonna do it. YOLO swag, I don't give a fuck. I'm gonna talk about my Z and talk about all this shit that I love. So, you know, stay tuned for all of that. I'll be posting a lot of new stuff on my channel this year, so be ready. I'm about to open up for you guys in like a huge way. I've never opened up this much before, so yeah, 2022, big things. Thank you guys so much for watching, and you know, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. Yeah.